Welcome to Apartment Syndication Made Easy podcast, where we simplify the world of syndication. Join us as we unravel the complexities and provide you with valuable insights to help you invest smartly. Get ready to take your investments to the next level, one episode at a time. Here's your host, Mr. Vinney Smiles Chopra.
Hi guys, Vinny Chopra back again. Hey, thank you so much for liking all the content you're watching and seeing on my YouTube channel, on the shorts and reels, on TikTok, on Instagram, Twitter, LinkedIn, Facebook pages. Thank you so much. And this is the sequel that I do, Apartment Syndication Made Easy, the book I wrote. And of course, Positivity Brings Profitability. Two of these books together. I have a great guest here today. You're going to love her. And she is Tiffany. She's Tiffany Mittal, M-I-T-T-A-L. And, she's worked in the multifamily real estate industry for over 13 years. Both as an owner operator of the multifamily apartments, as well as executive in property technology known as the PropTech. I'm so excited to really dig into that. You would like to also know what these cutting edge softwares are doing. She has led massive growth in multiple PropTech startups, both in utility billing and payments technology. In 2020, we'll even talk about, because I'm doing investment as angel investor in several of the prop techs myself. So we'll have some common things to talk about. She launched her own prop tech startup, Utility Ranger, a tenant utility billing software system. In 2021, Tiffany pitched her new startup to 10X Incubator, led by Grant Cardone. Wow, that's awesome. And Jared Yelling, and they offered her a deal of a lifetime on the spot. I love that. We'll dig into all that. Now partnered with the 10X Incubator team, powered by Project 10K, Tiffany launched her new PropTech startup with her partners in February 2023, last month. Tiffany and her husband, Mark, recently relocated to Stuart, Florida. Actually, she was from San Diego. I'm from San Francisco, as you all can see in the background there, and have four beautiful children, Mason 11, Reagan 8, Mark 4, and baby Monroe 6 months. Welcome, Tiffany. It's such a pleasure.
Thank you for having me.
My pleasure. Sorry about the mix-up last time, but I appreciate your hanging in there. I'm so excited to get to know you and the prop tech, because I'm into metaverse, into crypto, into all these kind of cutting edge, NFTs, of course, and biotechs and all that. And actually, I've been founding some new companies. Cloud Defense is another one of my startup, clouddefense.ai, and all that. So welcome.
Thank you.
How are you?
I'm wonderful. Thank you for having me on the show.
Sure. Tell me, take back as to where you, you born in San Diego and all. Is that right?
Yeah. So from San Diego, we recently relocated to Florida, a little bit more of a landlord-friendly state, as everyone knows. But most of our portfolio still remains in San Diego, but we're actively growing our portfolio in Florida. So it's really an interesting way I even got into prop tech. Mm-hmm. I started with my husband in the multifamily space, owner operators, and he comes from a family of multifamily. His father and their family have about 3,000 units. And then we have our own portfolio of about 100 units and growing ourselves. But what we noticed is, like many of, your listeners, and I'm sure you, is what was really a struggle is, when you're a small operator or a small owner, you can't get these prop tech companies to pay attention to you. Mm-hmm. And so unless you have 1,000 units, they're just not interested. And so one of the things that we looked at that we were trying to use to not only grow our portfolio, but also use to minimize our expenses, was doing a RUBS program. And we went to many RUBS providers and said, okay, we want to start this. I mean, we're in San Diego. We're the bottom of the barrel for water. Our water costs were, you know, astronomical, and we couldn't get anyone to help us. You know, we just weren't big enough, or we had to, you know, say, okay, well, if you start with us, then maybe my family's portfolio will come, you know, secondary. But, you know, they just really weren't interested in us as a small owner, which really put us at a disadvantage, which was frustrating. So at the time, I had just gone out of grad school, and my husband said, you know, instead of helping me with the operations, why don't you go work for one of these prop tech companies? And maybe they'll take us on by default because you're working for them. So that's what I did. I worked for a smaller, you know, utility billing company that was based in San Diego. I was employee number four. I took them from 100,000 to 20 million in 5 years. And I saw firsthand why we were having to turn away people, small owners with under 1,000 units. And it's because it's a really manual process. I'm sure you do RUBS on your building. By the time you send the utility bills and they send you back the pre-bill, and then you say, okay, I think I have a leak on one of these properties, I need to send it back to you, and you send it back to me. This process is just so archaic, and it doesn't really benefit the prop tech, you know, company to help these small owners, because they're only getting paid per bill, and all this back and forth communication is really time consuming. And so, but what we noticed when we deployed this on our properties, because they did take us on, as my husband said, by default, you know, when we went to deploy this on our properties, a year later, we looked at one of our properties, 36 units in El Cajon, actually, California. And a year later, we had 36,000 of additional revenue, which doesn't seem like a lot, but it comes out to about $1,000 a unit per year. But that 36,000 of additional revenue, when we went to go refinance that property, Freddie Mac valued our property at $1 million more just because of the utility billing program. So you took that 36,000, divided it by our cap rate, and that's the value that we created. And we looked at that, and it was like a light bulb went off. Like, if this can be done on one property, what does that look like across our portfolio? What kind of value are we not, you know, realizing because we couldn't get anyone to help us? And so I worked for a number of other prop tech companies, got recruited out a couple times. And time again, I kept seeing the same issue come up of these small owners who just, you know, couldn't get anyone to help them. But if I could have my one property increased by $1 million, and that, you know, took our whole portfolio and increased by multi-million dollars, what does this look like for the small investor, and kind of what disadvantage does that put them at? How can they grow the same way the big guys have been growing when no one will help them? Sure. And so at that moment I said, you know what, these small investors, they don't need these prop tech companies. They just need a tool to do it themselves. And so I was determined at that point to create a SaaS version of this, a SaaS RUBS billing platform that owners can go in and get rid of all this back and forth, make it super simple, put in their utility bill amount, press calculate, and email all the bills to the residents. And so that's what I did. I my husband said, okay, here's some money to start your prop tech company. I started my prop tech company. A year later, I realized the reason these big companies aren't going after the small investors, or the long tail of the market, they'll call it, is because it's really fragmented, right? It's not like this is the primary job of the owner. They might work for some big firm and own some units on the side. So it's not like they're advertising on LinkedIn, like, I'm a multifamily owner. Yeah. And so I realized we needed a node. And who is that node that all these small owners follow? Was Grant Cardone. And so at that moment I said,
hi, you are listening to Syndication Made Easy podcast. We will be right back after this short break.
Hi, thank you so much. This is Vinney Chopra, and thank you for subscribing to my podcast and YouTube channel and Facebook pages and all the great things, and LinkedIn. Connect with me. I come live to you every Friday at 9 Pacific with Vinny and Bo show. Please also look at that. And also the podcast, which is my apartment syndication made easy. The book I wrote a couple of years back became international top seller on Amazon International now. And then we like to bring great guests for you every week or twice a week sometime to give you a lot of great knowledge. So please subscribe. You give us 5-star reviews on the iTunes. The better the guests we can, you know, bring, and our ranking will go higher also. Thanks again for following us and really getting the most out of it. Please comment, like, share, because we would love to bring better and better material for you.
Yeah. And so I realized we needed a node. And who is that node that all these small owners follow? Was Grant Cardone. And so at that moment I said, I need him to be mm-hmm. my partner, because yeah. his whole audience are my target market. And all of them are at the same disadvantage that we were at. Like, mm-hmm. how can I help them grow their portfolio the way we were able to increase our valuation, do a cash out refinance and buy another property? How can I teach others to do it the same way, unless I have a tool for them to do it themselves? And so when I pitched my company to Grant and the 10X Incubator, yeah. they offered me a deal on the spot. And so they bought half our company. And a year later, we just launched. We're coming out of our beta. We're just getting ready to do our full launch, and it's March. And we're really excited. You know, we're finally kind of leveling the playing field and democratizing the prop tech space and giving these owners the same tools and the same advantages the big guys have been using for years, and making it really simple in the process.
I love it. I love it. I mean, talking is my language. You know, at the peak, we had 153 people full time in my management, Monil management group, which is one of the companies up there. Yeah. And we had almost 7,500 units. You've sold off quite a bit. But key thing was, you're right, lots of owners, small business people, they won't take the time to build the residents back. We never say tenants, you know, mm-hmm. residents back. It's cumbersome. And or they will do flat fee. Is that mm-hmm. another way to get that, you know, money as extra income? But you're so right with the cap rate multiplier, the value of the property increases when you are able to recoup, because all our assets were not fully bills paid, it's called. That's the term. If you don't charge the RUBS, then yep. it means you are paying for, well, they pay for electricity anyway. It's individually metered, but mm-hmm. water, trash, gas, termite, and all that. Most of the residents, you know, love to pay. They should pay, but a lot of the difficulty comes how to build them. And that's the thing which you are solving. I'm really, yeah. really happy to hear that. And you do it by email, I just heard, mm-hmm. right?
Yeah, yeah.
What's the gist in the background? So the owner will put in the bill for that month, mm-hmm. which they will get it. Actually, it's about a couple of months old, to be truthful, because it's coming from, you know, about 60 days or 30 days older. Mm-hmm. But still, go ahead, please.
But it's a little bit different. So I'll touch on the kind of delay of the bill, because yeah. that's problem with service providers. By the time that bill actually gets used, yes. you're so far behind for trying to get paid. So that is a problem, and our software does solve that. But to touch back on your flat fee, I think a lot of small owners, they resort to flat fee because they won't have someone who helped them. They won't have a service company help them, but they know they need the bill back. But what that doesn't solve, and what our software does solve on this, is if you bill a flat fee, mm-hmm. that just becomes a rent increase to a tenant, right? What you're really trying to solve here is you're trying to modify the behavior of your residents. So for example, if you go to a hotel and your shirt's wrinkly, we all do it. We all put it in the shower. Mm-hmm. We shut the door, we turn it on hot, and we let it go for as long as it needs to go until it gets unwrinkled.
We are not paying for the hot water.
It's included with the hotel. Well, our residents think the same thing, right?
Like, yes.
I had one of my residents call and complain that her neighbor was, you know, running her water all day. So we sent our on-site manager in there. And what did she find? The lady wasn't even there. She wasn't there because when she got back that evening, we said, why are you leaving the water on? You're not even home. She says, well, my dog has anxiety when I leave and barks. So if I just turn the shower on, my dog doesn't bark. And I said, I'm footing the bill for this. What are you talking about? You're leaving the water on. So even if you're charging a flat fee, that doesn't modify the behavior because you're trying to change. Like, even if it's a $10 bill, you're going to think twice before you leave the faucet on when you're brushing your teeth or doing dishes in the dishwasher with four dishes or doing a load of laundry with two items of clothing. Yes. It's, you need to change the behavior of your residents by making them accountable for the bill. And you can only get that accountability when the bill fluctuates with the actual bill. And so right now, the traditional process, if you're using a company, you get, let's say you have a bill for the month of January. I get the bill in February. Yeah. I give it to my billing provider, who's probably already billed for February. So they're not going to use that bill till March. And I'm hoping to recoup this in April for a bill I got in January. Yeah. The delay in this time frame is just such a problem. But if I take that third party out of the equation, I get the bill in February. For the month of January, I put it into the software and I email it out due with rent on the first. I get the recoupment of that bill 15 days later rather than 60 days or more later. And now I'm in control rather than saying, oh, I forgot to tell you, I have a water leak on my property and all the bills went up. I need to change the common area deduction or the amount that the owner wants to pay. Mm-hmm. And then you go back and forth until the bill amounts are where you want them to be. And all of that time delay is a huge headache for the owner. And so if you can just pull that out of the equation, do it yourself, you literally put in your utility bill, put in the dates of your utility bill, click calculate, it shows you a pre-bill. You look at the pre-bill and say, okay, do those bill amounts seem accurate? Do I have any water leaks or anything on the property? And you can adjust your common area right in the pre-bill. So then you can just send it out to your residents. So you basically eliminate all this back and forth with these companies. So then now you're in control, you're getting the bill, you're getting recouped for that bill. And that's increasing your property value so much just by billing your tenants.
Additional income. Yeah, additional income. Because in the expenses, we are paying in utilities, the water. Of course, common area water, if you have swimming pool and all, if there's no leak and all, that'll be okay. But this is, we just talked about water. How about trash and pest control and common area? I'm just thinking about us. Trash is a big one.
Think of all these industries, right? That when you have commoditization of prices, so of rental rates, think of commoditization like the airline industry's unbundled and started charging you for baggage, the hotel industry, right? They've unbundled and started charging you a resort fee. When you have this commoditization of rental rates, you really need to unbundle and say, take these variable expenses to help me stabilize what my rent is and pay for that separately. And so it's just a way of unbundling it, but it's not just, oh, this is something that you bill your tenants. It's not just about billing your tenants. It's about creating a mechanism to grow your portfolio, a mechanism to grow your wealth just by taking your third largest expense and turning that into utility revenue.
For sure. No, I totally agree with you. I think what I really love, the also change of behavior. Yeah. Because when you know that I'm going to pay that flat fee of $80 for the water, then I don't care. Yep. But if I have the gumption that I could reduce that for me for next month and so on like that, I would change my behavior so that I can pay less and have more latte or whatever. So in your software, are you able to line item it, not only break just the utility part of it? How about if there is a trash? So can you give percentage also of equal trash, I guess? I don't think they can.
It's really flexible. So you can put all your utilities. So whether it's water, sewer, trash, anything that needs to be calculated. And then it allows you to also put in resident fees. So you might have some standard fees in your lease, like storage or pet rent or parking fees.
That was the next one I was going to say.
Valid trash. Your rent. So yes, all of that can be added on one consolidated invoice, and it has a little pay now button. You pay your bill, goes directly into your bank account, and yes, you cut out all the middleman of this. So it makes it really simple. Again,
no wonder Grant and his team said yes.
Well, I mean, there's this huge underserved market, right? Yes. Of these small owners that no one will service. Like, yeah, there's no reason that they should have a disadvantage. We want them to grow as much as everyone else. And the only way they're going to grow is if they have the right tools to do so. We did this on our properties. We saw tremendous growth. We did this with my in-laws' properties. They saw tremendous growth. There's no reason that anyone who's doing multifamily doesn't have the right tool to help them grow.
I love it. I love it. I'm so glad to have you on the show. So let me ask you a question. This is coming out now, SaaS model, mm-hmm, in March, which this is March, yeah, right now. Yeah. And where do people go, and how would they, and how much would it cost? I mean, there are different systems or different,
there's two different pricing models. So it's Utility Ranger is the company. So you go to utilityranger.com. Uh-huh. And there's two pricing models. So let's say you just have one utility that you want to build and you just want to keep it simple. And we count water sewer as one utility. So let's say you go in and you just want to build a water sewer. You don't want to build trash, or you don't want to have any amenity fees. You don't really care about that. Yeah. It's $2 per unit per month, but that $2 is then put onto your residence invoice. And so it essentially becomes free for the property manager. Then we have our $3 version, which is unlimited utilities, unlimited fees. You can still add rent. And then you can actually increase your admin fee, because when you do it yourself, you're technically becoming your own utility billing provider, right? Mm-hmm. So you can add that fee. So at $3 a unit per month, you can actually pass along that fee to $5 a unit per month, or whatever your, you know, area specific. Everyone has a little bit different of a regulation in their area. But if you want to pass it through, you can make $2 a unit on the fee, because you're putting the work up front. Yep. So it actually is free for the end user as it gets passed through to the resident, and actually becomes a revenue generation tool.
Which is true. I mean, I'm just thinking a lot of the properties we had where it was built by the outside third party, mm-hmm, they will charge $350 or even $450, I remember.
And they charge open fees and close fees.
Yeah,
and late fees.
Exactly.
All of that is removed, and it's just a per unit fee that gets passed through to the resident. And then you can increase that fee and make money for your work of putting forth the bills each month. But I said, it's really simple, and it's really just a mechanism to help apartment owners grow.
I love it. I love it. I think everybody should really listen to Tiffany and Grant Cardone. Yeah, he's 50% partner in the company, you said, yep, you know. That's fabulous. I think this is exciting, because always when we are looking at how to increase the income, which is what we are doing through the RUBS reimbursement of the utility bill back system, we call it RUBS in our language. And it could be into not just multifamily, into other sites too, you know, where we are doing. And I'm thinking about some other places would be, of course, mobile home. I don't know if we have...
It works for mobile homes, for HOAs.
It's
basically doing what commercial properties have done for years, which is turning your property into triple net.
Yeah.
Right.
You're
renting the airspace and everything else is extra. I mean, you're seeing in Class A real estate. Now, most of our properties are Class B, Class C real estate, and hoping to move into more Class B solid.
I'm more into kind of classes now, because I can raise millions of dollars.
Exactly.
But I started from a duplex.
Yep, exactly.
We still own it. And 14 units, and now we are buying $63 million, $75 million deals, you know, which happens,
But you're seeing in the Class A, they're you know, charging amenity fees now.
Yes,
So that is going to trickle down as even the utility billing has trickled down. And so it just takes a while. It's like the Class A, they get all the newest technology, and then you need players like me in the market who says, how can I make this available for the everyday investor, and just even the small investors who's just getting started?
I love it. I love it. No, that's so exciting. So exciting. Thanks for sharing that. let me ask you a question now. You do have, you know, little kids, so excited, you know, growing family. I know you said you're near West Palm Beach. I'm in the Fort Myer area, right there in the Punta Gorda, Cape Coral. I'm building over there in Palm Bay and other places, assisted senior livings and multifamily. I own in Melbourne also there. And I just sold my Bentley at Maitland over there in Orlando, bought for $52 million, sold for $64
million. Wow,
good one. You know, good hit run there. Then, but no, this is exciting. I'm really glad. I think Florida is a great place. I'm next week, I'm in Arizona. I'm buying a lot of stuff over there now because of I'm really into multifamily senior assisted living with Silver Tsunami.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Well, it's such a pleasure. Anything else you'd like to add, you know, to the audience? You've, you know, given such great software, guys. Please, please remember, you know, you got to go to that. I think it's in the background for you. I'm trying to look at it. It's called Utility Ranger.
Utility Ranger. I'm happy if they want to go to utilityranger.com. There's a free ebook on there as well, how to get started, called Pay for Your Water. And you know, it's I'm here. If they want to reach out to me, I'm happy to give them some guidance. A lot of people have questions like, how is this legal, or is how do I do this in my area? So I give that kind of information to my clients along the way, just so they have a comfort level of doing the billing. It's not as hard as everybody makes it sound. I always say, you know, the idea of doing your own utility billing is about as sexy as doing your own taxes. You know, like, you definitely don't want to do your own taxes. It kind of is scary, but really when you peel back the curtain, it's not that difficult. And we've made it so simple that anyone can do this themselves. And I think the more we can cut out the middlemen, the more we can actually bring more revenue to our properties, focus on our growth, and focus on the things that are really bringing in money.
So true. So true. No, so nice to have you, Tiffany. And again, good luck to you.
Oh,
all
thank
the success
you.
To you and your husband and your family. And I think it's a tremendous software. I mean, you know, if I had looked at it, I would have partnered with you. This is something that is universal, and it's one SaaS model, which I love, like cloud defense. I just did the scarletbooks.ai, which is QuickBooks on steroids with artificial intelligence. I'm just putting a plug into please go to scarletbooks.com, which is amazing software. You can do as many LLCs, accounting in the dashboard, everything right there. Then Metaverse, then Plug XR, where we have designed this new cutting edge. Like I said in the starting, I wanted to mention it to the audience also. I will be going big time into promoting these startups, which, you know, I've been a part of. I'm on the board and everything anyway. When he tries to get into something, you know, in every
absolutely.
Tiffany, thanks. Any lasting comments before we sign off? Yeah.
Thank you for having me. I really appreciate it. And anything I can do to help your audience, I would be very happy to do so.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And God bless you. And, you know, I'm so glad you came. And we'll see you next time, guys. If you like the content, please give us 5-star reviews. Share this episode with all your friends who own multifamily, even the smaller, 10 units, 15, 20, 30 units, 100 units, because this can change your pocketbook, the net income. Because if we are able to get the residents to pay for the utilities, that's what this show was about. You can increase the bottom line cash flow, or NOI, net operating income, and you divide that by the cap rate. That's the increase in the value of your asset. So here to you for making more money and doing well in your business. See you next week. Thank you again, you know, for joining Vinny Chopra this week on this podcast. And please subscribe, share, give comments, and give 5-star rating if you can on iTunes, because that really helps a lot for us to bring great guests. And also iTunes raises our rankings up.
And I hope you have been very happy with Vinney Chopra and team, who are able to bring great information. If you would like to invest with us, please go ahead and go to vinneychopra.com/invest. Thanks again. God bless you.